I wanted to start off our manufacturing day this year with a couple of really fun facts. I know we have a national and international audience, but you know, I wanted to brag on Missouri manufacturing just a little bit because a few of our folks that are watching today are watching here from Missouri, and wanted to share some fun facts about manufacturing here. In the state of Missouri, we have actually 6,681 manufacturers. Of that number, 80% of those manufacturers are less than 50 employees. So lots of folks doing lots of great things out there. We have over 277,000 manufacturing employees in the state of Missouri. And our gross state product income is actually through manufacturing is $39.8 billion. So as manufacturing is healthy and actually growing. And the average salary of somebody that works in manufacturing after a 10-year period is actually $72,838. So manufacturing, not just really inching along and worried about paycheck to paycheck, you truly can have a great career and income from this great thing that we call manufacturing. You know, as a glimpse into manufacturing, you know, Cambridge is a culture that we grow our leaders and we always strive to enrich their lives. And you'll get to hear from our employees today, and we'll talk a little bit about a program that we have called Cambridge Unleashed, which is unique to the manufacturing sector and something that one of our great leaders, Meg Brown, had come up with a couple of years ago. And we are excited to talk a little bit about that as well today. So what we're going to do is we've got a video to kick this off. This is a little bit of a glimpse into manufacturing Cambridge style, and enjoy. Hey, that was actually created by our own Jesse Hummel and marketing team. Great job, guys. Really, really well done. So, you know, here at Cambridge, we talk about cultures that grow leaders. And, you know, one of the great things at Cambridge is that we encourage all of our employee family to take opportunities to grow as a leader. What you're seeing in this actually slide is Mr. Kramer leading one of our morning meetings. And what those really do is you're able to take the microphone no matter where you are in the company, whether you're the CEO, you're part of the admin team, you're one of the folks that work at Break Press. What we do is we encourage you to take the microphone at a morning meeting and walk our entire company and whatever visitors are there that day, since we tend to have a lot of visitors always, through our metrics. We talk about this, we talk about safety, we talk about quality, we talk about delivery, we talk about revenue. And then we allow our employees, and again, all our employees are paid to be part of our morning meeting and really just communicate with each other and really break down those barriers that tend to sometimes happen in the workplace. You know, part of this also is something that we call lean and clean. At the end of our meetings, we set aside 15 minutes of time for different sections of our company to go around and actually work with each other and clean our offices and do things like that. And you might say, clean offices, what that do? Well, candidly, some of the best camaraderie that I've been able to build at Cambridge is honestly during that lean and clean time when we're vacuuming or when we're changing out the paper towels or whatever we're doing. It is a meaningful part to my day at Cambridge, and the morning meeting really kicks that off for all of us. And really gets the day going. So you all start seeing that in manufacturing across the country. People have been doing stand-up meetings for years. Ours tend to look a little bit different, and we absolutely invite you to experience one of our morning meetings virtually or in person. If you'd like to do so, you can. There'll be contact information at the end of our presentation today. So Thomas, I'll have you go ahead and kick up to the next slide, if that's okay. So we talk about cultures that grow the leaders. We absolutely put that at the very forefront of what we do, and that is growing our folks here at Cambridge. You're seeing a slide here with one of our marketing leaders and also the head of Dale Carnegie. And what we did here was we had the entire company participate in ways to just share how we can improve communication and empathy in all situations. And it really was, you know, I actually was not employed at Cambridge at this time, but in preparing for this presentation today, folks told me that was one of the most important meetings that they've had, because again, we all think that we know how to communicate until we get into these situations, and the tools that we were able to give each other by working with each other and learning from leadership at Dale Carnegie was really important. Some of the other things that we do to grow our leaders is we include every person in the company that wants to be part of our vision to help create the vision for the next, you know, 5 to 10 years. This year, we actually worked with Zingerman's in a format called Zing Training Envisioning, in which we worked towards a future that we all created together. So, you know, we worked to create the job matrices for clarity around career development, but most of all, everything that goes on at Cambridge is really developed by our employees. And to me, it's a unique opportunity. Manufacturers are really on the forefront of changing the way that we communicate and they communicate to their employees, because they have to. You know, manufacturing, the stigma around it has always been a little bit difficult, but when you see what folks are doing today and really for the last 5 to 10 years, manufacturing is a really amazing opportunity for folks to take a look at. First of all, you can earn great income, but second of all, you're continuously learning. There's always process improvement. There's always a lot of these companies now to develop culture, and you can get as involved or as uninvolved as you like. But what happens when you join Cambridge is everybody seems to want to be part of the fun and what we do on a daily basis. So I won't go into a ton about enriching lives. You know, enriching lives for us is something that we actually redeveloped as a tagline a couple of years ago as we decided to embark on this journey to make sure that employees and our culture were first. What do you mean by that, Tony? I'm sure you're asking, or maybe not. You know, when you look at companies like Cambridge, there's always a front of the house meeting where the folks, the executives and admin and engineers and people that sit up front are in a different part of the building than in the factory. Well, what our goal is to break that wall down between the front of the house and the back of the house and really encourage folks to interact with each other. And it happens on a daily basis. It's actually one of the reasons I joined Cambridge was for the culture, and it hasn't disappointed. And what's even more interesting is that employees in our facility are encouraged to make videos when they find improvements. And we have over 1,000, maybe even over a couple thousand videos of process improvements that our folks do on a daily basis. So we have lots of fun at Cambridge. It's a lot of hard work, but at the end of the day, we are a family, and people can really say it, but if you come to Cambridge and visit, or you just check out one of our morning meetings, what you're going to find is that it really is an authentic culture, authentic atmosphere, and a manufacturer that people want to seek out to be part of. So we're going to go ahead and kick this into our Enriching Lives video. What you'll see on the front of the screen is that's John Kramer. He's our CEO. We have been a family business for many, many years. And John, I'll go ahead and let you take it away.
As I've been in business for quite some time, I've wanted to rally people around something, a cause or reason why we exist.
Cambridge exists to
glorify God
by enriching the quality of every life we touch.
I get to tell a lot of people about that, why we exist, and whenever I just share that that's not a faith statement about every single person inside of Cambridge. It's simply an acknowledgement that the business that we call Cambridge is about something much bigger and much grander than just profits.
It kind of knocks people off balance a little bit. They're not really sure what to think of it.
We believe there's something bigger than us, and we're going to conduct ourselves in a way that we're responsible to something bigger than us.
We want you to feel unconditionally loved here, exactly as you are.
If I can be unconditionally loving to those around me and just love them for who they are and not what they're doing for the company, then it can be transformative, and it really does walk out the why.
The glorifying God, why we exist statement was finished by saying how we were going to do that. We were going to glorify God by enriching the quality of every life we touch, whether that's the people that work here, the people that come to call on us to sell us parts for our equipment, or externally when we go out to solve problems for our customer.
And it's something that's a lifetime. It's a journey. And enriching lives, it's not a destination. It's about people.
Enriching lives is about promising to do more than heating a building.
Because it means that anytime you come in contact with the body of Cambridge, your life is going to be better for it.
This is who we are. It's what we strive to do. Do we do it perfectly? Absolutely not. But we always aspire to be better at it.
Really, the culture has been something that means enriching lives all the time. It's just now that we get to write it down and share it with you.
There's something about the Cambridge experience and enriching lives that has been here for many years. We're just saying it the right way.
It's almost like it's just a final piece in a really beautiful process that we've been a part of.
And so I love it. I love the fact that everything, every sticker we put on, every business card we give out, every piece of logoed stuff that I wear or anybody wears is actually going to say, we are Cambridge Air Solutions, and this is what we do. We enrich lives.
I love that video. That's actually was made, I think, about a year ago. And, our why statement is a big piece of who we are at Cambridge. And we encourage you to ask questions about that of our panel a little bit later in the presentation. But I think next we're going to hear from Becca, who has done so many things since she's joined Cambridge. And she really is one of those folks that, you know, when we talk about Cambridge and enriching the lives of our employees, Becca and you'll see a few other people later, and Thomas and Jesse and all these people that, you know, started here just thinking that they were joining just to have a job. They've all realized, hey, this can be a career for us. So let's hear from Becca and Thomas. Please go ahead and take it away.
I wear many hats, and it's important that I wear every single one of those hats. You know, I'm not just operations engineering technician. I'm not just mom. I'm not just wife. I'm not just church member. I am all of those things. I'm the culmination of those things, and that makes me unique and kind of defines what I bring to the table.
Being a whole person is not just concentrating on work separate from everything outside of work. Being a whole person is you have your work, you have your family, and the balance between that, I think, creates a whole person.
I've had plenty of jobs in the past to where you get there and you're not so much a person. You're basically there to do a job. You're not there to make friends with anyone. You're not supposed to kind of put yourself out there. You basically show up, you get the job done, you go home.
You know when somebody genuinely is asking, hey, how are your kids today? Or, hey, how are your kids? Okay, cool, did you get this done? You know, just be genuine and actually care and remember and follow up with the people that you've talked to. Maybe it doesn't have to be, 10 people. You can start with one or two.
The better you feel as a person, the better work you're gonna put into something. You're gonna show up to work happy. You're gonna show up to work ready to work, and it's just knowing you don't have to balance out work and family and only set aside time for work and only set aside time for family. It's huge.
I think about times when I solved a problem in a unique way for my kids, or I solved a problem in a unique way for my church, or, you know, with our finances at home or whatever. I draw on all of those experiences to help me solve problems here at work. So I don't think that I could even do my job well if I was asked to just come here and be an engineering technician. I couldn't do it.
Being able to come in and share your feelings or your emotions or kind of putting yourself out there, you know, it's kind of freeing. And the fact that they care about your family, not just so they can get a product out the door, but because they genuinely care, makes it so much more enjoyable to come back every day.
The absolute juxtaposition between a place that doesn't care about you at all, they just want what they can get from you and how can you help me, to a place that wants to know how you're doing and how are these things that you're struggling with, or how are these things that you're celebrating. Tell me about that. They want to know. It's amazing, amazing.
So before we hit this next video, Thomas, I just want to comment that, you know, those are genuine. It's about as authentic as it gets. I guess that's what I would say about those folks. And what we would tell you also is that if you take the time to come into our facility, we would encourage you to ask our employees, anyone in the factory, to be real candid. What they think of Cambridge and how it's changed their lives, and, you know, and what it's done for their peace of mind on a daily basis when they have to wake up and leave their family and come in and go to work. You know, it's really leaving one family in the morning to come to your work family and then going home hopefully better than when you came in that day. The next video is actually really cool. It actually talks about one of our customers. The MLS soccer team, Real Salt Lake, we actually had the opportunity to heat their huge facility out there. And I've been lucky enough to go see it. But, you know, Cambridge, you know, we touch the lives of so many folks. And, you know, you hear big names like Amazon and Coca-Cola and you name it. And, you know, we heat and cool a lot of their buildings. But what we do with these folks is not only just put units on their building, but also, you know, follow up with these folks and actually show care and compassion to our customer, even after the fact, by writing white papers, taking on partnerships, and really whatever it takes to make sure that our customer is a customer for life and not one just at the moment. So with that being said, Thomas, if you wouldn't mind to kick off this next video. Thanks, Thomas. That was that's a pretty cool video. I haven't actually seen that one yet. You know, again, we get the opportunity to do some really unique things with folks that you'd be like, wait a minute, you know, what are you doing? That you're an HVAC company. What are you doing out there? But everybody needs to have a climate controlled atmosphere, especially when you're talking about enriching lives of your own employees. So right now, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and kick it off to a panel of our employees. And everybody is absolutely welcome to ask questions. I know we have some folks that they're on just audio. We've got folks from Utah. We've got folks from Colorado. We've got a lot of folks from Missouri. But the most important folks right now, besides yourselves, are three of our very own here at Cambridge, which are Thomas Little, Smegan Salter, and Jesse Hummel. And, you know, they've all got interesting stories, and I know we don't have all day. We want to be respectful of your time, but, you know, what we wanted to do is open up the floor for questions or conversations, really, about who we are, what we do, what you guys might have around manufacturing. And this is the time for that. And really, if you don't feel like asking questions, that's okay too. We don't want to force that, but this is a really great opportunity to talk to three folks that started in one place in our company and have really started to climb in their career paths. So with that being said, I will, we will look at for the next 30 seconds to see some questions that are coming direct to us in the chat and go from there. So. Okay. This is from this is from Darren in St. Peter's. Darren asks Smegan, tell when did you start? What are you doing? And my daughter is interested in a career in manufacturing. What would you tell her?
So I started out back in March. I was building remote control station cans, which is basically where the thermostat lives for our heating units. And so I would wire those and test them and pack them up and send them off. And right now I do, I'm in a position that they call water spider. So I do a little bit of everything. I help get the crates ready or create the units and get them ready to ship. I help assemble the units. I cut wires. I build various parts that go on our control cans. And so I just kind of do a little bit of everything, which is cool because there's always opportunity to learn. And that's kind of what I would focus on for your daughter. Like there's always room for growth here. And Cambridge is so willing to help you grow not only here, but outside of this facility in your home lives or your personal lives, or if you have other goals for your career, they kind of help foster that. So I would just say like I feel like manufacturing is a good place to start when you don't know where to go. Especially here at Cambridge, because they help you kind of figure that out so much.
That's awesome. Thank you, Smegan. That's really cool. We have a question in chat from Carolyn Ty. Hopefully I got the name right. I apologize if I didn't. Oh, thank you. Good. I got the thumbs up. So we're okay there. So this could be for Thomas or Jesse. You guys get to choose on who wants to answer this one, but you both have a ton of experience here. How many people does it take to produce a single heating unit? Let's call it S. It's like one of the S units, let's say.
It's kind of an all hands thing. If you mean people that physically put it together and assemble and all of that, maybe 20 people-ish, 20, 25. But it's everyone because we have everyone from the guys that ship it. We have everyone in sales that help actually sell the unit. It's kind of a whole company thing. Even the material handlers and people that, you know, bring us all our parts and organize things, supply chain people. It's kind of a whole company thing. I started off assembling the beginning section of our heating units. And I would say that there's probably around 20 people that have their hands on them. All three of us have some knowledge around that, but I'm not sure if that answers your question.
That's awesome. Hey, Jesse, how many units can we make in a day on the S line just in one shift? Because I know here at Cambridge, we actually have two shifts. But Jesse, you might know on this.
I would say anywhere between 10 to 14, 14 if things are going real smooth, but probably on an average day around 10, maybe 8 if things are a little slower, but right in that range.
That's awesome. And then guys, and any of you can take this, but I might pick on Smegan again, since she gave such a great answer earlier. You know, did you have any manufacturing experience before you started your job here or your training to do this?
So personally, I did not. I came from actually the world of education, was looking for a little bit of a break and ended up here at Cambridge. And everything that I know, Cambridge has taught me. So
that's cool. And one of the things I want to highlight about Smegyn, other than the very cool first name that I had never seen before, was that, you know, Smegyn actually has a true interest in helping adults with developmental disabilities work in careers that they had not really ever had the opportunity to choose. So she has asked me to connect her with facilities that can help maybe folks join our facility, which is coming to fruition through a training program out at Boone Center in St. Peter's. So, you know, Smegyn will play a big role there. I don't think she ever thought coming to put together heating units that she would actually realize some of the dreams that she had in working with adults with developmental disabilities. But, you know, at Cambridge, we get to make some of those things happen, which is a really unique opportunity and something that, you know, something that I think we need to talk about more, but we just haven't. So Smegyn, awesome work there. And, you know, Jesse and Thomas, same question. Did you have any real manufacturing experience before you started at Cambridge?
No, I only had, I didn't really even understand how each tool worked, to be honest. And I came in, didn't know anything, just saw the job posting. It's really cool though. They helped me out throughout the way. We got this thing called standard work where they make it real easy for you to understand how to do each job. And then once you do get an understanding, allow you put input in as to how to make the job better, actually, even if you don't have experience. So it's really neat to see how that worked. And then coming in with the team that supports you and learning every step along the way and then being part of the team, you know.
Very cool. Thomas, can you give us, is it okay to pick on you a little bit here?
Yeah, absolutely. I had a little bit of minor manufacturing experience from my family. My family had a chain of metal fabrication and kind of do-it-yourself creation things for whoever wanted it. So I had a little bit, and that was in my late teens, but I learned pretty much everything here. Hope that answers.
That's awesome. We actually just had a question come in from Caitlin at Lindbergh School District, and she wants to know, how do you gather the courage to pick up a microphone at a morning meeting and actually lead the way? Were all of you, hold on, let me see. Yeah, were all of you guys outgoing to start, or was this something that took courage for you to build up and learn to be patient and, or not patient, but actually be courageously uncomfortable, maybe would be the term there.
I got this one. No, it wasn't easy because, you know, you come into a new place, you don't know everybody, you don't have a lot of experience public speaking, but they set up a team for the meeting that kind of does everything for you and helps you along the way. And then whenever you see everyone else doing it, it makes it so much easier because it's not just the president giving the morning meeting or the CEO where it seems like a big task. It's really a group effort where everybody's doing it. So you feel like, oh, this is, you know, what we do. And then once you have that opportunity to lead the meeting, it's really cool to kind of grow in that way and become better each time you do it. And eventually it's just a breeze because you're just doing the thing you've done 100 times, you know?
It's true. It's amazing how much we learn from each other too in those morning meetings, because essentially you can talk about your family, you can talk about what you do on the weekends, you can talk about your career path, all whatever you want to talk about. It's all game and actually great. We had another great question, Carolyn. She's asking, can you talk a little more about how everyone participates in your vision development? I believe at least two of the three of you were part of the Zing training, but maybe all three of you, Thomas or Jesse or Smegyn, who wants to take that one?
I can talk a little bit to it. It was an open invitation, I believe, company-wide to join the Zingerman's training. And it was very, very cool and very interesting because anyone that wanted to would join and participate and influence our future goals and help set that up. But we met for, I want to say it was a couple hours, I think. But it was a very cool process where they laid out a very easygoing kind of map that we could kind of build and talk through as a company, from the owner and our high leaders down to people that worked every job. And it was just very cool that everyone had input and it was all taken seriously. And we just kind of built from there. And it was just a fun, you know, process to go through.
Yeah. And if I can be a little more conversational about this, I think that for me, because it was pretty early on in my time with Cambridge when the Zing training happened, You know, putting me, who's just really more business development, my title's manufacturer ambassador, which is kind of funny in its own right, but with folks that would be on the line or folks that have been here for 25 years. And, you know, I coming in from the outside, I have a different opportunity to say, hey, listen, I think we should start to look at, you know, the next 5 to 10 years and whichever way I had talked about it. But you had all this amazing tribal knowledge of folks that have been here for so long that gave you a little bit more of like the history and the why and how we got here and where we failed and where we've succeeded. And I think that to me, as a manufacturer, that was like, that's like unheard of. So the opportunity that brought for all of us to talk to each other and share what we thought Cambridge should be, not just in revenue, not just in product development, but also in people development. Because when you talk about the branding of Cambridge, you have to talk about our employee brand and our internal brand, because that's what keeps us ticking. Yes, we make the best product out there in heating and cooling, but at the end of the day, we have authentic relationships with each other and we build that way. But yeah, Carolyn, that was a great question. Thank you. And Carolyn, who are you with there? I wanted to ask.
I homeschool my son. So
awesome.
We try to participate in Manufacturing Day every year. My family's background is a little bit in manufacturing and he's on a robotics team. So just trying to see what's out there.
How cool is that? They didn't have robotics, I think, when I was growing up. I think they had sweeping the back room and some of the other things. So that's how I learned it. But anyway, great question. Thank you for being here. It's great. And I think that, you know, the strength of Cambridge is really found in good relationships. And really the integrity of good relationships is trust. And we have a lot of that at Cambridge. And, you know, trust comes from positive intent and a collaborative spirit to support each other. And, you know, we do talk about enriching lives. We talk about a lot of those things, but, you know, without integrity, without authenticity, without great leadership from the bottom to the top. And most people will say top to bottom, but really with us, it starts with the employees first. I think that that's what makes us unique. And, you know, Carolyn, if you guys ever want to jump in to a morning meeting, I'm getting a bunch of messages now. If you guys ever want to jump into a morning meeting, we absolutely welcome that. You can do it through our website. Yes, Utah, you guys can come to. And Justin, here we go. So of all three of you, we'll just get one of you guys to answer one of these questions, if you don't mind. What does your career path look like over the next 1 to 3 years and then long term after that? I know that's a tough one. You're scratching your beard. Jesse, you want to take it?
Yeah, I can go ahead.
Megan can take it. Yeah. Whoever wants it, that'd be great. Yeah.
So I actually came to Cambridge. Going back to school and being here, I've realized it is at Cambridge that I can pursue that fulfill that same kind of drive in my heart to work with people who have special needs. I guess I can't answer the question for sure, but I can definitely answer the question and just let you know that, like, through coming to Cambridge, I have learned how many opportunities there are outside of, you know, the traditional kind of path. I would like to at some point just get more involved over the next 3 years, get more involved with the special needs and just helping the adults with developmental disabilities and training them, but then also working with the people who are on our floor who don't struggle with those things, kind of start to understand and learn how to communicate and teach those who do have those everyday struggles. I guess over the next 3 years, it would be nice to get involved in that at Cambridge.
That's amazing. And it's on my goal list, even though I'm not your boss and we don't get to work together that often, Smegan, to make that happen. I think that I think it's an amazing opportunity and candidly one that motor manufacturers should take a look at when you're talking about employing employing folks. It's all folks, right? It's not just one group. And Cambridge has been great at that. And in St. Louis and in Missouri in general, we're really lucky to have a lot of manufacturers that have that that same spirit. One more question. This one is to, I'm sorry, I'm having trouble seeing my screen. This one's actually to Jesse. Jesse, where did you start in the company and what are you doing now?
I started out on the M line doing, getting it ready right before it ships. And then I moved over to the gas trains on the S line and I spent a few months doing that. And then I got lucky enough to start an internship with the marketing team over the summer. And then now I'm actually full-time signed on to the marketing team. So I started out on the floor building stuff, didn't really have an idea, and then kind of expressed to my leadership that I would like to make it a career here and displayed some of the skills I have with writing and video making, and got lucky enough to actually sign on full time with the team and marketing. And here I am now.
So I have a question about that. We use the term courageously uncomfortable. At least I do. I don't know if you guys do, but Jesse, was it hard to go to your boss and just say, hey, you know what? I love what I'm doing back here on the S line or M line or ESC line, you know, but I have greater goals for myself and my family and all that stuff. Was that tough? I mean, was that hard to come up with that courage, or did you want it bad enough? You're just like, I'm going for it.
Yeah, I mean, I had thought about it for a while and I didn't say anything, but we actually had touch points where you sit down with your leader and discuss how it's going or what can make you happier. So that really made it so much easier to say something because I didn't have to walk up to his office, you know, knock and say, hey, you know, this is what I want. I got to have that moment one-on-one where it was set away for that. So made it much easier, but it still took some courage for sure. It's never easy to say you're not completely happy with what you're doing, but it worked out.
And I've heard you got a cool boss now, so I'm not sure. I'm not even sure if she's on here, but she is. She's one of the coolest. So anyway, I think, you know, I want to be respectful of the time. So what we're going to do right now is wrap things up if there aren't any more questions, and invite everybody that from around the United States that's watching today to please get in contact with us. If you want to come visit us, depending on what's going on with the surroundings, we absolutely would love to have you in person. We absolutely can to make the thing happen virtually right now. You want to attend a morning meeting? Would you like to go on an actual plant tour? We can do all those things. So we really want to be part of the greater community. We want to bring manufacturing back to a point where it is a cool thing to do. And you know, on the other side of the coin, it's, you know, you see all the supply chain issues and everything going on around the world. And, you know, manufacturing was what really grew our country. And now manufacturers are being leaned on again to make that happen. So we are hiring at Cambridge. We have an amazing program called Cambridge Unleashed. Essentially, it's a 4 to 6 month training program. It's not so much seasonal anymore because we've gotten so busy. So really, we do hire certain times of the year for this, but Cambridge Unleashed is a really amazing opportunity. You get to learn 2-second lean. You get to learn many different jobs here at Cambridge. And we offer full benefits and PTO. There's full-time and part-time. Folks can start 18 years or older. And really exciting to announce that we are now in not just in Chesterfield, where we've been for many, many decades. We are also out in Wentzville. So we're expanding our employee base. We're expanding what we do. We have some really amazing product introductions coming up for 2022. But right now we're gonna enjoy Manufacturing Week, have a great time with our employees. We actually have Taco Tuesday today. So we're actually making tacos for all of our employees at both facilities and really just having a good time. And I think at the end of the day, even though it's not probably politically correct to say, we do have a good time at Cambridge. And I think it's important for everybody to know that. So with that being said, I want to thank everyone for being here today. Our panelists were fantastic. Carolyn, thanks for the great questions. Thank you, Justin, on Utah and everybody else that's watching through our other link. And have a terrific rest of your Manufacturing Week. And please do not hesitate to reach out to us. We'd love to be part of any conversation that you have around manufacturing.